This is an after-action report for Flashpoint Campaign's Red Storm. Today, we'll be playing a scenario from the Germany Reforged downloadable content. Because there are so few scenarios for Flashpoint Campaigns, we cherish each and every one of these new scenarios, because once you've played a scenario, it's kind of, the fog of war is kind of spoiled. So, look at these new scenarios as the first time I've ever played it. We'll take a look at the scenario background and our orders. We'll see that the scenario length is only 4 hours. It's quite a short scenario. And we'll examine our forces. We have a helicopter, I guess, troop. We have 4 pairs of Kiowa and 4 flights of platoons, I guess you would call them, of Apache attack helicopters, and the headquarters element. Plus, I have a little multiple launch rocket system off map, as well as a flight of warthogs. Let's examine the map. We'll see that our startup area is in the southwest, and there's a single victory point location on the map. We examine our orders and see that we need to win approximately 1/4 for victory. So there's 8,000 victory point locations, so we need approximately 1/4 of them. So we need to destroy the helicopters cannot seize territory. So even if we flew over this location, we could not seize it because we have no ground units. So this one is automatically going to go to the enemy, no matter what happens. So if we take no losses and everything else, we need approximately inflict 2,000 victory points on the enemy in order for a marginal victory. We'll take a look at the map and see and examine the terrain. It's nice to have total fog of war, that I have no idea whatsoever what the enemy has and where he starts. But we can make a few educated guesses, hopefully, from just examining the layout of the map. We can see that this is our starting area and the enemy victory point locations. So I'm going to presume that the enemy probably starts somewhere in the northeast or east. Of course, he could be starting here as well. I don't know. No idea. But I think it's unlikely that he'd be starting on the same side. So we've got a mountain. It's in the bottom of a valley. So we have some mountains on the north and through the south here. Each of these, we'll take Control E to bring up the elevation, and we see that these are level 6 and level 5 mountains, hills, high hills. So because we start over in this location, and I think the enemy is going to start over here, we are effectively blocked from the enemy by these hills, which is good. At least we're probably outside the field of fire for any enemy surface-to-air missiles, and the Soviet surface-to-air missiles are quite potent. We could hit F6 and take a look at what the enemy has in what kind of forces, but that's taking a little bit advantage of the game. Yes, the game allows for it, so it's not cheating, but I'm going to try to preserve the fog of war as long as I can. I'm only going to make decisions according to what I see on the map and what I detect. So let's see if I can think up a strategy for this scenario. Here's my strategy. We have a 23-minute first cycle. So I have ordered all my helicopters into resupply in order to maximize their readiness and ammunition. we're pretty close to maximum already, but I only get a chance once. I may as well do it now. So it'll cost me the first 46 minutes or so as we wait for them to resupply. The reason I'm doing this is keeping them low. I'm putting them on the ground here pretty much as low as possible to keep them below the radar horizon. So we're fairly well surrounded. If the enemy starts off in this location, I'm going to be toast. We can move a couple of them here onto level one hexes. By keeping them at level one elevation, I'm on the ground as they resupply, so they shouldn't be detected by the enemy, even if he happens to show up in this area. With my headquarters element, I'm going to be flying a little bit of a reconnaissance mission. We're just going to fly up behind here and back down. We have special avionics trying to detect the enemy radar from his surface-to-air missile air defense units. See, in the game, it's not a bug, but it's kind of a, I'll call, bad behavior. The enemy surface-to-air missiles, their air search radar is on all the time, and it can't turn it off. So we hopefully will be able to detect some of the emissions, and I'm going to be using the multiple launch rocket system to try and smash a few of them. It's only 4 hours. It takes approximately 30 minutes. It fires, it resupplies in 30 minutes, and so on average, it's going to fire approximately every 45 minutes. With four turns, that I might get off 4 to 5 barrages. And I'm going to use these to try to take out the enemy surface-to-air missiles. Suppress them, destroy them, whatever, but at least it'll give my helicopters a chance. Now, the enemy's going to be advancing onto this. That's his objective. He's got to come take it. What I'm going to do is I'm going to resupply my helicopters. There's no point throwing them out here just to get the living daylights shot out of them as they come over the top of these hills and silhouette. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to use the first three or four barrage, 3 hours, maybe three and a half hours, to try and kill as many surface-to-air missiles as possible so that the helicopters can at least stand a chance flying in here, because we know that the enemy AI tends to congregate around the victory point locations. I'm going to hide either here or here to, in case there are any leakers or up through this way, to shoot at them. But we'll try to keep the mountains surround. We'll try to stay in the bowl of where the mountains are in order to protect ourselves from the enemy air defense units. So we're going up here. We're going to sniff it. I'm also going to drop my... There's no point in risking the warthogs. They're very slow moving, and the enemy air defenses are... The SA-10 Gremlin... SA-11... I don't know what that... Forget the name out. SA-11s, SA... Pretty much any surface-to-air missile is going to easily make short work of them. So I'll resupply to maximum, but we're going to hold off on everything until we can actually use the multiple launch rocket system to smash a few of the enemy air defense units. That's my plan. Let's see how it works. Here we go. The helicopter makes its flight, and we detected some kind of a flicker of here's air search radar. Now where the hell did my helicopter go? It's invisibly moving back here. Okay. We detect, here's air defense unit. Well, we detected one down here somewhere, but obviously we don't see it now, and we'd have to check the replay to find out where it was. But we can see this unit is heading to in a northwesterly direction, and we can see it's heading here, over here. So what we've done is I've called the mobile launch rocket system. We're going to drop it right on top, hopefully with a little Kentucky windage. He'll advance here, or maybe even here, by the time it drops, and we'll plaster everything, we'll hammer him, especially in the open. It's even better if he's in the open, because the multiple launch rocket system bomblets will be even more destructive. I have the helicopter, and we've decided we're going to land it and try to bring her readiness back up over the next 30 minutes. Here we go. He disappears from detection. But we got more rocket, more surface-to-air missiles here and here. Looks like he's moving up the road and down the road here. We blast the area. Let's see how. Let's count fireballs. Let's hope that we have a few. One. I think we got it. We got three of them only. Damn it. And our unit, it displaces to avoid enemy counter fire. But we still see him bouncing around through here. Our helicopters are refueled. And he flickers again. These flickers are really annoying. We can't slow them down enough to find where what's happening. As we start the third turn, it's important to our helicopters are resupplied, or except for the headquarters helicopter. But it's important to note that I'm going to bring up the options we're playing under, and we are playing with the fire support control center deactivated. Unfortunately, since version 2.9, the fire support control center is mandatory. This means that the AI just takes my fire assets, either aircraft or artillery, and just does whatever it pleases with them. It could fire them, and what I'm worried about is it might just take these bombers and try to bomb these units, even though I know it's a suicide run. So we'll have to keep aware of this, and we'll try to keep them out, but there's nothing you can do about it. You can't stop the AI from doing this, all right? So just so our viewers will be aware. We see that here's a surviving SAM unit and another SAM unit against the river here. There were a couple of other flickers, but we don't know. Could this be the same one? That's quite a distance he's traveled, but theoretically it could have happened. It could have happened. I'm going to gather my helicopters up in this area, all the while carefully keeping them below the crest of the hills, so they are not silhouette against the sky for the enemy to shoot them out of the air. Now, because helicopters, I think the stacking limit for helicopters is 2 per hex, so sometimes by flying them into a large area, it's careful not to jam up, because if the two helicopters arrive early, they can act as a blockade. Really, yeah. Two helicopters and a hex will prevent other helicopters from flying through them. And I don't know if this has been changed in 2.10, but that's something that's always to be of concern. So I have made sure we're sending some of our helicopters, making sure that some of them are on delay so that all the helicopters can arrive or at least reach their destination without blocking each other. My fire support, it continues to be rearming, and my headquarters, let's take a look at the points. We haven't killed, that's not bad, killing 219 enemy losses for how many, we'll check the reported claims, and that was, two tanks! So we got tanks as well as air defense units. I'd much rather get the air defense units, because the tanks, well, they're great, but the helicopters can at least have a chance against the tanks, whereas they have no chance against the air defense. Here we go. Oh, there go his SAMs again. Still moving. No white dot of counter detection, so we haven't picked up any radar on this side of the valley. Look at all that flicker. It's really hard to keep track of them. It's a good thing that we are making a video so I can check back on the video. Otherwise, how would anyone keep track of all these? Looks like we're going to have to hit this one next turn. Our helicopters arrive. Now notice the helicopters, since 2.09, helicopters cannot go into hold position. They are only able to end with a screen mode, which is just a throwback to version 2.04 when they didn't have these end path orders. So the game has taken giant leaps backwards, and the enemy has captured the victory point location. And Steele continues to swarm the area with his surface-to-air missiles. My helicopter's just waiting behind the hills now. Unfortunately, just because we're within range of the enemy, look at our readiness drop. 25% loss. For nothing. We're not threatened. There's nothing the enemy can do to us from his side. But hey, the AI, we just keep losing readiness. Now, this is not a bug. It's just I think it's illogical. So I'm going to be moving my headquarters up here because these units cannot resupply unless they happen to be within 3 hexes of the headquarters. This is a real bad throwback to version 2.04 or so. Previously, a helicopter, you could fly the helicopter back here, and then at the end of the turn, it would at the end of its path, it could drop into resupply. Now you can't. If you fly it back here, you have to wait another turn in order to just click the resupply button. It's not a bug. This is deliberately bad programming, in my opinion. A badly programmed behavior. So, but instead of the helicopters being some of the most flexible and versatile units, they're now some of the worst. Because now you've got to sit around waiting for 30 minutes just so you can click the resupply button. This is deliberate programming, not a bug. I've decided, okay, notice there's no enemy surface-to-air missile units on the board. We can't keep track of them. It's a good thing we're making a video because I rewatched the video part and I see that there was a surface-to-air missile unit here heading in this direction. So we're going to try to drop another saturation bombardment on here. Maybe we can catch it. Here we go. There it is. Did we catch anything? Wow, he's moving quickly. Headquarters unit, no. But did we catch? I'm looking. I don't care about the headquarters so much. I am looking for the air. There, we did catch an air defense unit. We just can't wipe the bastards out. Here's another survivor, and another survivor, and another one down here. It only takes one launcher to shoot down my aircraft and or my helicopters. We'll check the situation report and see that we've inflicted 600 points of worth of damage on the enemy. That's not insignificant. That's fairly respectable out of 2 barrages. But we're only getting 1 air defense unit. So killing all the rest is, pointless. If we can't get the helicopters into the play, we've lost track of them again, but our multiple launch rocket system is in resupply, so it's kind of pointless. We're holding the helicopters back, and I'm trying to drop them into resupply, try to get that readiness back up, but I was sloppy, and now because this unit's too far away, we can't resupply. So I have to fly him back just so that this guy can resupply. Yeah. Okay. Here we go. And look at all the flickers. Here comes something around the corner, and we engage with anti-tank guided missiles, killing a reconnaissance unit. Here comes the air defense units into the city. Looks like they're going to congregate, looking for the high ground, perhaps. And something else is moving up. Headquarters has been detected. We don't care. Notice how we do get some air defense detections here. He's moving in a northwesterly direction still. We're leading the enemy again. We're going to try to drop it right on his path of intended motion. So hopefully we'll catch him here or here. This is our third. We desperately need to kill his air defense units. One fireball at least. Lousy! One fireball! Hopefully he's heading up this way. I'm hoping that he doesn't have enough to see over the top of the hills. That was just a terrible bombardment. What a waste. 45 minutes of waste. With an hour 46 remaining, we might have time to, for one, maybe even two bombardments before sacrificing the helicopters. This one SAM unit down here, it's on a level 2 hex, and it can theoretically still shoot all the way up to here if I bring my helicopters into this area. So if I held them back and used the terrain here to block the shot, I would probably be able to fly no further than maybe here or here. That might be enough. Let's see. His SAMs continue to move forward. Let's hope they don't come all the way out here, because that would mean a lot of trouble for me. Here comes his other SAM unit. Look at him fly through there. His tanks appear. I don't know what they're doing all the way over here, but his tanks do appear. The rocket launch system is back, and we're going to try to drop it all. I think they're congregating around this victory point location, so maybe we can smash one more of these air defense units. Because my helicopters cannot go into hold position, we are using long delays by holding them here. So he'll wait here for 15 minutes before trying to move southward. This is about the only way to actually hold them in position, as this helicopter was over in this position, but because he's on screen mode, yeah, he runs away from his enemies. Yeah. So in order to force him back into the fight, I'm going to fly him here, hold him here for 12 minutes before allowing him to retire to the south. Hope with a little luck, we might be able to smash this enemy tank unit. Here we go. Here comes his surface-to-air missile units. The helicopters engage. Well, it looks like this one just decided to fly. And we engage on the as he moves up on the hill. More fire. Lots of secondary explosions. Where's that? Here's the multiple launch rocket system. We got two of the air defense units. Hopefully this will make enough. I think the third one has already escaped to the south, damn it. Two fireballs at least. Hopefully that will be enough. No, damn. He's still alive. Another air defense unit here smashed, and what about this last one? Not enough to destroy it. He's still got air defense units here. And look at that SAM unit down here. And the headquarters is detected further to the south. We don't care. We continue to fire on his tanks as they move back now. They're trying to retreat, but we've got him in the open, not open ground, but caught on the silhouette against the hill, and we keep firing and firing and can't kill it. Come on, Apaches! They should be just slaughtering him with their Hellfire missiles, but no luck. We might have time for one more rocket blast, and I'm trying to bring my helicopters in, trying to kill off the remnants of this tank unit. Currently, we are at 1,300 points. Still not enough for a contested battle, even, or a marginal victory. But I hope I have destroyed enough of these surface-to-air missile units, and maybe one last shot on this one. So, I've got my helicopter Cobras here trying to resupply. Unfortunately, because they're within range or visibility of the enemy, I'm not sure they're going to resupply. The headless chicken mode dances of version 2.09 pretty much dictate that if the enemy can see you, I'm not sure he's going to allow me to resupply, but all we can do is see if this silly behavior continues. We bring the helicopters back up to try to engage these tanks. Oh, we've got another tank company that's appeared. We fire and fire and fire and fire and fire and not much. We kill one more tank on the hill. The Apaches aren't doing too badly. Kill another tank. We want to wipe out this tank battalion. They're worth 1,000 points. We're going to be out of ammo before the battle even starts. Don't even need to penetrate the city, as we won't have any helicopters with which to do it. Two flights of helicopters are down to half supply, so I'm trying to bring up this other one to maybe engage the tanks we detected here and up here. And my third one is still under resupply, trying to finish off her resupply cycle. I've got my rocket launcher again, and I think I'm going to go after the SAM unit here in order to bring in the bombers. I've called in the flight of bombers to try and strike this tank unit here. So hopefully we'll wipe out the air defenses before the bombers arrive, or it could be a very short air raid. Here we go. The helicopters move up, pick up the enemy tanks. He fires on us, we fire on him. There's that air defense unit still. We haven't detected another, so we're holding up here and we're engaging him across the valley. Another fireball. We got one, two. He fires back. Look, he's still in this hex, but he doesn't see us. See, we've already pulled off. There is no way to hold the damn helicopters in the position. He had a great firing position, but there's no hold command in the helicopters. So they drop into screen and run away. The rocket launchers drop their barrage, and we have several fireballs. What a waste of a mission. Two, I think we've wiped it out. The scout helicopters stay, but the other ones do not. Pretty odd, hey? That's the attack helicopters run away, but the scout helicopters stay put. And sit here and get shot. I think they shot one. Yep. They killed an 140-point Apache for nothing in return. We kill another tank on the hill, but it's not worth an Apache. A second barrage arrives of the rockets. But I think we've already destroyed it. Yeah. We continue to try to fire and take fire from a hidden source. The Apaches fire again and destroy another tank. The airstrike comes in and we hit. We're evading air defenses. Under heavy fire, they abort the strike. We lose another Apache because we just can't see it. He's jammed against this helicopter and he cannot fly away. Look at him. He's trying to fly in here and he's jammed up between these two flights of helicopters. As I said earlier, the stacking limits are two helicopters. Really? You have a stacking limits of helicopters. They keep firing and firing, but they can't get away. Look, this one unit down here, they don't kill anything, but they don't escape. Looks like it's almost the last turn. Two turns left. The rocket launchers are out again, but I'm going to try to bring the airstrike back on top of this juicy target here. The helicopters, after getting shot to ribbons, are going to drop them into resupply, even though there's only 28 minutes left. But I'll try to recover some of the readiness in order to shove them back up in here for the fight. I'm waiting for these other helicopters to finish their reload before we send them in. This helicopter is trapped behind these because there are two here. That means because there are two helicopter units in these hex, you can't fly over it. You're trapped. So I will try to move them here. up to this location so we can all fly in together next turn. Let's see how it goes. Now, of course, the helicopter isn't smart enough to actually move. He can't move. Oh, he actually did. He manages to evade, fly over everything. He couldn't do it southward, but now he can go towards the enemy? Just bizarre. And now he's trapped again against these two. So he flew over these two helicopters, managed to get himself into a really hazardous position, and gets the living daylight shot out of him from everyone. We fire and kill a lousy reconnaissance unit, but we see everything in the hex. Everything here now. So will we bring in the rocket launcher, hopefully, onto this position next turn? And we lose another in exchange for a 2-point or 10-point reconnaissance unit. We lose another 140-point helicopter. The air defense comes in. We're evading, and we're bombing. The A-10s finally managed to deliver their ordnance. This is going to be the perfect place for a multiple launch rocket system next turn. We're getting fireballs from the tanks. Let's hope we knock out 5 or 6 of them. That's 600 points. Nope, we got 2 from one unit. This is a full unit. Will we be able to catch 3 or 4 more? We got exactly 3 out of a stack of 16. That's terrible. Just terrible. He continues to fire. And we finally managed to retreat. So, sometimes the double stack prevents us. And the weather just turns to shit. So the enemy cannot be engaged. It is interesting to note that in some instances, we are unable to fly over a double stack of helicopters. But in other instances, it is possible. Just bizarre. And I don't think he can control it. If the AI does it, maybe. But I just have no idea. Alright, last turn. And of course, the enemy gets weather so that we can't call the airstrike. Plus, he'll be able to shoot my helicopters at much... I can't see anything. So he'll be able to shoot back at us and probably drive off the helicopters long before we ever get in range. So we're going to shove them in there anyway. Maybe we'll get a few more. Right now, we have already won ourselves a marginal victory. But I'm not willing to just sit on it. Let's see if we can't kill a few more. So we're going to shove them in. I've got the multiple launch rocket system dropping in here. We should be able to get one more strike at them. Let's see how it goes. They fly up and we are detected. We're firing, they're firing. We kill the reconnaissance unit. All of 12 points or so. And we wipe it out. Now we have to go after those juicy tanks. We've got a rocket launching system dropping on here. We kill another reconnaissance unit. It's all wiped out. We're coming in nice and close to use the guns. We destroy another tank on the hill. 2 fireballs. They're gathering. He's actually moving in closer. We'll get our rocket launch system, our rockets dropping here just before the end of the game. So, the last strike. We're not getting anything from the helicopters. The weather's just so poor. We do get one after all that firing. We don't have to worry about the enemy, our helicopters pulling away, because it's the end of the game anyway. We just hope they don't fly in here and get hit by their own rockets. That has happened. The reconnaissance helicopters retreat. The attack helicopters continue to shoot it out and get nothing. All I can hope for is they don't get blasted out of the air. They advance and drop into a screen position. Lots of shooting, not much explosions. Here comes that rocket system. 1 minute before the game duration. We hit 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 companies or survivors. How many will we get? So far, 2. They're in motion, so hopefully we'll get a few more. 4. Oh my goodness, we missed all these? 5. And we caught them all in motion. Incredible. Just incredible how bad it is. Oh well, I think that's enough. Here comes the last 30 seconds. And the helicopters are fleeing for their lives in hasty movement, the most exposed posture possible. And the game ends. Since our units' helicopters cannot exert control over influence, the enemy is awarded 8,000 points for the victory point location. We have managed a tactical success at 80, with our forces at 83%. We've killed 31 tanks. I think it was just this lousy weather at the end of the game. We just can't see anything. We caught all these tanks in the same multiple launch rocket system, and we killed 5. Really, 5. That's what, there's 10 here, approximately, let's say 10 here, 20, 30, 40, 50, and we got 10% of them. Just horrible. My helicopters are on the retreat, but I think that if the weather had held up, we probably could have gotten a few more. This concludes A Few Good Choppers with Flashpoint Campaigns Red Storm Germany Reforged.